Today we're doing the final review video for the Cat Power Tower, which is this modern cat tree that Charlie and Trig are currently on. And as you can see, it has three different levels, and we'll go through all those levels. But I wanted to mention first that I did an arrival video, and in that video I show how I put it together. It took me about an hour, but I think if you're not taking a video and just putting it together, it would only take you like 30 minutes or so. It's so well thought out as far as how it interlocks and how sturdy it is. It's also relatively heavy, so that's good because then it keeps it more sturdy. I know, Bubby, what the heck? And it's a little bit wobbly on this floor of mine just because the floor is uneven. So that's obviously not something to judge it on because of my floor. So let's start out with all the different platforms. So the first platform is the hunting platform. And as you can see, there are different holes and you can put toys or treats in there. And I have a video on YouTube of that. And then there are Andy, the creator of Cat Power Tower, has these carpet squares that you can put on the hunting platform, and you can arrange them however you'd like. And I'm putting them like this so that they can jump up to the various levels. However, one of the videos that I did, somebody was concerned about, you know, their cat breaking their leg or something. Trig and Charlie just jump straight to the second one. They don't even jump on the first one. So I wouldn't necessarily worry about that. Now, the second platform that Trig is on has this piece that when the cat lays on it or sits on it, it will activate the carousel that's up there. And the carousel, this one is the bird carousel, but there's also a carousel for scrunchy balls, which I will replace and show you how that works. And it's really easy to pull off. You just pull it off and replace it. And in order for it to rotate, you have to have it plugged in. So I will show that as well. And there's a switch over here that turns that on and off. And then Charlie's on the top level, and it's just a carpet level. And this whole carpet piece comes off. And I'll do my best to show you that later as well. Bub, what the heck with the nails, man? So what I found is great is you just pull this off and then vacuum it and put it back on. And also, if you know that your cat likes to sleep next to a ledge or something, you could always just pull this carpet piece off and put a blanket in there, and then you've got that much of a ledge for them to thanks, psycho killer. All right, let's continue with the review. Bub, give me my thanks. One thing I wanted to mention about these platforms that come off is that, any get you off of theirs. Hey, what the heck? You can also store toys under there. So if you've got guests coming over or whatever, that's a possibility. There's also this scratching platform, and it is just a sisal board, and it's 27 inches tall, so that's another place for your kitty to scratch. Charlie was, man, you are frisky, was just scratching on this scratching post, which is also sisal, and it is 32 inches high, so great for a large breed cat that wants to stretch up and really get the full stretch. Nice, Charlie. Poor cat. So something else to mention is this is completely customizable. If you contact Andy and you say, hey, I don't want the scratching post, I just want two carpeted platforms and the hunting platform, he can certainly ship it to you however you want it. If you don't want that scratch board, I think that you don't have to have that. If you don't want the hunting platform, you could have two carpeted ones. So there's really an opportunity to customize it to your liking and what you think that your cat will like. But this is how it comes standard, so wanted to show you all of that. So without further ado, I am going to get the AC adapter to plug into the back. I think it's back here. I don't know. I'll find it. And then I'll show you how that works. Okay, so that's plugged in, and it's actually plugs in underneath. So if you're trying to get your bearings on that. And then it has a switch down here that if the... this door that Trig's sitting on is pushed down, then it will automatically turn. So I'm going to try to get Trig to jump back up on it to show you how it's activated. And right now I have it set so that if it is pushed down, it will activate. Let's see, I might need to get a cat wand toy. Bub, you coming down this way? Come on. Come on. This is when you wish you had a dog. But I don't wish that for very long. Chi, go up this way. There you go. Okay, see how it engaged when he jumped on that? They haven't really dealt with this that much because Charlie's got it stopped with his nose. Just because I haven't had it plugged in, I don't really have an outlet in this room that's ideal. And they've been having a fun time laying on it with the windows open since it's now fall. I'm going to put the scrunchy ball one on top and see what happens. And you might, you know, if your cat's like feathers, great. If they like scrunchy... foil balls, that works too. I got a little bit worried about the feathers with those bells hanging down, because Trig and Charlie took those apart pretty easily, and see how Trig jumped off that platform and it stopped? Nice job, Chiggy. Now, you can make it go without, so if I move that switch, now... it is activated all the time. So the cat doesn't have to jump on that to activate it. And this is a good time to show you. That's all it does. It doesn't even go down that much, maybe a centimeter for them to activate it. So here's the foil ball attachment. And if your cats already chase foil balls, then they more than likely are gonna go for this. So you just pull it off and it has that little hole. And then replace it with the other one. And then we'll turn it back on.
See, what's making that noise? That's weird.
Oh my gosh, look at Chiggy, so stinking cute. Take it apart, bub. You can see how this is an all-in-one type of toy. If you are looking for... if you live in a small apartment or you're saying, listen, I don't have the funds to keep buying stuff, I mean, this is really all in one because you've got your hunting platform, you've got a scratching platform there, you've got a scratching platform there, you've got places for them to lay, places for them to play. I also wanted to point out, this is really good for large breed cats. I mean, Charlie and Trig, we have tested one other cat tree, and it was way, way, way too short for them. And this allows you know, them to be ragdolls and not smaller cats. So I think it's a great purchase for large breed cats as well. I wanted to touch on, you know, if you're concerned about putting it together, Trig is eating the sisal. Hey, how about we stop that? It comes with awesome instructions, and I'll show you. So it's all visual, so it's very easy to follow, and you don't have to necessarily understand what's written because you can kind of see by the photos. But Andy also, the creator of the Cat Power Tower, has a video on YouTube of him setting it up. So you can follow that if you kind of get stuck in a rut and aren't sure what to do next. It's all covered in his YouTube video, which makes it a lot easier to handle with the setup. Okay, Charlie isn't thrilled that I pulled him off, but I wanted to show you how easy the carpet platform can be removed. And I believe that Andy can put a different material on these rather than the carpet if you'd prefer. So this is what I was talking about, putting a blanket in there. And then the underside of this is, I think that's MDF, but you can see that it's put together well so that it's not gonna shift a lot once it's back up on that. It is quite heavy, so I was struggling there. Charlie's checking out the instructions. Okay, so a few more things. As far as the price of the product, there's a link in the About section of this video, and I will do my best to keep that updated with any promo codes or sales that the Cat Power Tower has going on. And you also might want to check out Cat Power Tower's Facebook page. It features Pat the Cat, which Andy does, and it's hysterical. He makes the funniest comments and the funniest photos and stuff. So well worth it if you're on Facebook and enjoy following cat pages. And I'm going to end... Oh, this is also the natural finish. So, you know, it's just, I think, a light coat of polyurethane. I want to finish up with the hunting platform. So you can put toys or treats in there. And I know that there's been some concerns from a couple of readers, like I mentioned before, that the cat jumps down or the cat jumps up and, you know, breaks their paws. So it's virtually impossible when you have these two carpeted pieces positioned like that for the cat to jump down into the holes. So if that's a concern, there's the solution. If that's not enough of a solution for you, then you know, certainly can customize it and ask Andy to give you an extra one of these to put down there. So these are the little mice that Andy sent me to put in the hunting platform. So I'm gonna do that. Try, man. He's already pulled one out. And I think you can buy these mice through Andy. I'm not quite sure, but certainly you can ask. But you can put any toys in there. You know, if you have like the foil balls on the carousel up there, you could definitely put those in the hunting platform. It's... it's big enough. Catnip toys. We usually do treats, so I'll do treats too. Now Charlie's playing with it out of the box, or out of the hunting platform. So So I'm going to do treats next, and we'll finish with that. Okay, so next are the treats. And I just put them in the hunting platform, and I take the two squares off so that they can access them from any angle. Charlie and Trig really love this thing. I find them on it all the time, and both of them are on it. Either Charlie's on that level or Trig is, and then vice versa. So I've been really impressed with their taking to it. I thought Trig would like it a lot, but I didn't think that Charlie would like it this much. So they have proven me a bigger lover of the Cat Power Tower than I already was. I've been wanting to review one of these for a long time because I thought that they were phenomenal, but now I know that they're phenomenal. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask. I definitely think this is an awesome, awesome cat product, and I'm really excited that Charlie and Trig have it so that they can play on it and enjoy it. We've really enjoyed having the windows open and them, you know, being at a different level with everything. Keebub. I mentioned in another video, but I'll mention it to this one. One of the great things is if you go to work all day, you could put treats in the hunting platform in the morning and have your cat work on it the rest of the day to get them out. So it can be entertainment like that as well. As far as those mice were concerned in the hunting platform, I don't think I would leave them in there unsupervised. That's just a gut feeling that I have. I have no, you know, reference to whether or not that is accurate, but I like to go by my gut, so that's why I'm saying that. If you like this video, I'd appreciate you giving it a thumbs up. Helps us review more products like the Cat Power Tower and bring them to you on YouTube. Also, consider subscribing if you like to hear about cat products and see reviews of them. See how they work before you buy them. We feature products all the time. And I'd love for you to join us on floppycats.com. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. I didn't want someone to tell me that, that's not fair, Chiggy's not getting treats, but Charlie is. As you can tell, that has been told to me before, and it's a little bit annoying. Get him, bub.
Get it. Where's it? You get it?
Bub, you're like, I already had my treats today because I already came in from outside. That's where treats are. Get him, bub. Get it. Bub. I also kind of, I don't know if you noticed that, but when they jump on and off of this or step on and off of it, you can hear it. So I always know when they're on it because I can hear that sound. And obviously it's not obnoxious. It's just, you know, once on, once off.